We are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Look at this. Chef and owner of the brand spanking new Post Office Cafe. John Granata is here along with the lovely and always talented TV maitre d'.
Good. I'm glad you're writing the script. It's all good.
It's all good.
Good morning.
Roasted sausage peperonata is what we're making today, right?
Peperonata. Peperonata is a sauce that hails from the Tuscan area. Basically what it is it's not just your plain old sausage and peppers. We're going to roast the sausage, the peppers, a little bit of fennel, some fresh tomatoes, all of this native. Right now is the best time.
Yeah, it's fantastic. Right?
I preach the local farm situation. You should always go there.
Sure.
Local garlic, local basil. And basically a peperonata sauce is a pepper version of relish, but it's not sour.
Okay.
All right. So, but basically what we're going to do is we're going to saute everything together with olive oil. We're going to finish it with some white balsamic vinegar because... Mm. The white balsamic almost gives it that sweet and sour kind of thing going on.
Yep.
And then we're going to let it cool, but we probably won't have time to let it cool. But the best thing is to let this cool overnight and then serve it with your sausage the next day.
Sounds good to me.
It, huh?
And then, as always, we'll talk about some delicious wine that you have here. And everything that's going on the television show. So that's what's coming up. We've got a great morning for you. Also, we'll be talking about the brand new Post Office Cafe in East Greenwich. Big stuff happening. Back to you. That's right, we are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Chef and owner of the brand new Post Office Cafe located in East Greenwich on Main Street. John Granata's here. TV maitre d' Joe Zito is also here.
I don't know nothing.
You don't know nothing. We are ready to go.
Yeah.
Ready to go. You got some oil in the pan.
So we're making a classic Tuscan peperonata. Mm-hmm. We're going to serve it with some hot sausage. I put the sausage in the oven because I want it to be ready at the end.
Got it.
The bounty of the land from all the farms. We got some red.
Great looking peppers.
Green. Orange and yellow peppers.
Mm-hmm.
And I just want to grab the onions.
Okay.
You know, we put the onions in there because if we leave them with these hot studio lights.
It
permeates
everything.
Never
turn out good, yeah.
Right. So, one large onion.
Mm-hmm.
I got a bounty of peppers there. Oh, 4 cups worth.
A bounty.
You said this is almost like a relish as well, and it's best to kind of prepare it.
Right. What we're going to try to do, and we won't be able to do it for the segment, but what I suggest for the viewers is that you make this and you put it in the refrigerator for at least 8 hours and serve it for dinner tonight or tomorrow even.
Got it.
Fresh fennel.
Looks good.
Has a beautiful anise flavor. We're going to throw that in there. We're going to let that all cook up.
A little licorice almost,
right,
you know,
yeah.
The anisette
sure.
and the whole deal. Sure.
Right. So what we want to do is we want to let that stew down.
Okay.
Right? And then we're going to add some fresh.
Like me.
Like you.
Stew down a lot.
Isn't that your alias? Stew down?
Exactly. Stew down.
So you're going to let this sit. How long will this have to kind of like sit for?
Well, we're going to cook this probably about 10 to 15 minutes.
Okay.
Let that stew down. We're going to finish it with the native tomatoes, some garlic, some basil. And the key is a little white balsamic at the end.
Ah.
It's going to give it a sweet and sour flavor. And actually, when it cools, it'll really come together.
So. Okay. Sounds good to me.
We are going
to do that. We're going to talk about everything that's going to be going on at the brand new Post Office Cafe on Main Street in East Greenwich. And also, we have some great wine that we're going to sample. Back to you.
Back with Joe and John in the Rhode Show kitchen. It smells awesome.
Yeah, it does.
We are making roasted sausage peperonata today. I gotta say, John has been a busy guy. He is about to open the new Post Office Cafe.
This is so great.
Just a couple of weeks,
happy
right?
About this.
Yeah, about a couple of weeks away, and we're doing all the finishing touches, and we're working really hard trying to get it done. And
down in East Greenwich.
East Greenwich, Rhode
Perfect
Island,
spot.
Right on the corner of Division and Main Street. It's been
11 Main.
An old post office for 80 years, and it really is. It's a beautiful spot.
Yeah. Brings us back to our roots.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's great.
Well, we're happy that you're sharing another recipe with us today.
Yeah, well,
the sausages you've already gotten cooked off, right?
The actual peperonata that I'm making is going to be on my menu. It's a very nice little thing to, if you're not very hungry and you just want to have a couple of drinks and you want to pick at something, this is a wonderful relish type thing.
Mm-hmm.
And it's served room temperature to cold. But you could also take it and lift it up a notch and do it with some sausage. Now, you can use any sausage you want. It goes well with that. So what we did was we're basically stewing in olive oil peppers of all different colors, onions, and fresh fennel. Yes. And you can smell everything coming together right now.
Certainly. Just trying to soften those up a
bit?
Yeah,
we want to wilt everything down. And we're not really concerned with having a little juice on the bottom because I'll show you that at the end why.
Okay.
We have some fresh garlic. I like to rough chop it or even slice it. Throw that in there. and native tomatoes, because, you know, nothing's better than that right now.
Yeah, especially in the summertime. You can use some from your own garden.
You're talking about healthy. I mean, we know we have the sausage, but I mean, this stuff is just fabulous.
Well, and sometimes too, you could probably use even like a turkey sausage or a chicken sausage.
Sure, or you could use sausage like Rob with Robbie and cheese in it, or like, you know, all kinds of,
they have so many now.
So don't limit the possibilities, you know. So what we're going to do is I'm going to let that stew down a little bit more. And then at the end, I'm going to hit it with a little salt and pepper, and I'm going to hit it with white balsamic. And that white balsamic will give it a little, what they call agrodolce, a little sweet and sour kind of flavor.
Perfect.
And what you really would like to do is cool this down for about 8 hours and serve it cold or room temperature with that, and you really will see a big difference. But we'll taste it at the end.
Okay, we're going to let that go for a little bit. Yeah. But to pair with this,
a beautiful summertime dish, and I'm going to tell you, one of the hottest wines now in the world is Riesling. People have discovered Riesling.
Huh.
And it seems like it's
summer, but it's all about Riesling.
It's a German wine, but everybody makes Riesling, and this particular one that I'm fond of for $10 a bottle, I might add, is from one of my favorite
Washington, right up my alley.
Washington State wineries. And this is Chateau Saint-Michel Columbia Valley Riesling. Now, Rieslings also can be sweet to dry.
Okay.
This is medium. Now, when the chef talked about agrodolce, this is a beautiful complement. It'll pick up the fennel. It's got a little bit of acidity, but it's smooth and it's clean and it's got very citrusy flavors.
Great.
So it's a perfect match.
It, like you said, and very delicious, I'm sure, in the summertime.
Oh, it's just a beautiful summer wine. And if you skew a little bit drier, you find a Riesling that's dry.
That's right.
On this
particular
bottle in the back, for example, has a little scale. Tells you where this one runs right in the middle. You can see it over there.
Perfect.
So, that's smart.
Well, it makes it really easy too when you're headed to a place like Gasparo's or something. Where I always see Josito on the television screen every time I walk in there. But it's nice to know.
And the billboard too. I'm on a billboard.
Oh yeah.
So
he's everywhere. And you're in our kitchen. Okay, so you added a couple more things to that,
John? Yeah, I added a little fresh basil, and I added the white balsamic. you know, this will be ready in a minute, but basically I just like to say that, you know, the Post Office Cafe is going to be doing contemporary Italian cuisine, so we're doing like a lot of like small bites, appetizers.
Which I love, because a lot of times too, you know, you meet friends out for a drink, and you don't want that full meal just yet, or maybe you did eat something, you know, not too long ago.
Right.
So having those little, you know, picky things like an appetizer or something like this is a great option.
And then the menu will be enticing enough, I believe, for you to get sucked in for that too. So.
What are some things that we can expect? Some classic dishes, I'm sure.
Yep, we're going to do some classic dishes that are classic to me. Like we do an ahi tuna dish. We do a veal chop with some black garlic and porcini mushrooms.
Oh,
they'll be very simple pastas, traditional, classic, but we're just
with a little flair.
A little creative flair.
Some of the things you saw me do on here, like the carbonara.
A few weeks ago.
Right? We did that a couple of weeks ago over here.
So that's great. So you serve that up, like you said, hot, just like that, or let it chill for a while.
We'll
really kind
chill.
Of let those flavors come together.
Some service you get here.
I know.
I mean, come on.
It's wonderful. You even cut my food for me.
Well, only because I didn't want you to burn your mouth on live TV, you know.
I appreciate that.
I don't do that for anybody.
They're always looking out for me. If you want this recipe, head on over to roadshow.com.